Okay, so we are laying the pavement at specific intervals to make sure that everything works okay. So that is Holly and this is Benji. So that it will be easier for us to work in the greenhouse. And you can see the layers of the pipes have been interwoven so that there's water everywhere. The sprinkling will go everywhere. So it looks like a snake goes all around it, making sure that we do not have any leftover. So that is it. So where he is, the next place, yes. The other place, yes. And then the other place, yes. So there are stumbling blocks or pavement blocks everywhere. Okay, so that is us laying the other side. So we can move to the middle as well. Or you can head into position. Okay, so this is how we do the footing. The footing is done here, and there's a footing there, there's another one, so that there's easy access into the whole greenhouse. You can see lizards behind, but they cannot get in. So that's the awesomeness of the greenhouse facility. Or then you can put it here, maybe where your leg was the other time. So you can see the sweet potatoes and their roots. Wherever there's a root, it springs up again. That's what we used it for, the base or the feed for the snails, meaning that everywhere you put it there will be enough of them sprouting so that there wouldn't be any. So this is the forward pavement. We have another one here, another one there, another one, just in case the client needs to go in and do some work. So that is the setup. Now we have the snails in, we are waiting for the water to come up, and then we will put in the, we'll sort of release the water. We'll release the water so that the snails can start moving. So as you can see here, there are even some starting up the journey. See, some have even started eating the vegetation. And we bring bigger ones, we don't just bring, and you can see this one has already been eaten. doing big snails. This is my hand, and look at the size of that snail. Huge ones. These are snails, and these are, there are a lot of them that are also bigger, not just point of lays, but layers or breeders. So these breeders are going to find their own way out. They're going to look for places to move on their own. So once the water comes in, it means that, look at that big snail over there, very huge. This one is already climbing. So people were asking, can snails climb up and go and eat the contumbra? Yes, they can. Some are down, they can have access to. Some are up, they can have access to as well. So this is an awesome day for us. This one is really in a hurry to go find its own living environment. And all these ones will also be, once we rejuvenate them with water, come on, they can start. So we're going to rejuvenate them. And see, there are even some with eggs already. So like I said, we don't just give you snails. We give you snails with egg-laying properties or abilities already. So these are even laying twigs. So that's the beauty of it. A wonderful day it is. Come on. We are at Oredu Farms, and then we brought snails. And as you can see, some are even laying already. You can see eggs there. Some snails laying already. Are the ones, and one, you've seen one climbing up there to eat. And these are all snails. So today is a Saturday. We are at Oredu Farms at the Siakwa in the eastern region, Bunsu, and then we've brought 1,800 snails to put in 3 greenhouses. We're going to bring the 1,200 more to fill the whole pen. So we are going to rejuvenate them with water. We have already troubleshoot the sprinkler system, and now we can just turn on the sprinklers. Okay, so these are the sprinkler systems. They're going to pour on the snails and rejuvenate them, give them more energy, and then you see that they will start moving out. See, now they're moving and all the sprinklers are kicking in. We have the sprinklers kicking in every part of it. And the snails are all there, moving about nicely. You can see them moving the leaves there. Those are snails moving about.